Hi, today we're going to try to put my idea of this on the canvas. So I like to use a black marker to first draw this on. Just draw the rough outline of everything. I also like to draw different things on here that I'll be filling in. Now, not everybody has the same skill set of drawing. That's all right. Now we'll start with that. We got our handy dandy easel here. Some black there. We'll work with the black for a while. Now what I did prior to painting here was do the background. Did the background on something slightly different. For some reason my hand's shaky today. That's all right. Clean up the lines a little bit later. And all these be painted black. Fill them in. going to fill in all the spaces in here, just the ones that define the beaver. Best thing about painting is if there's a mistake, make it part of the artwork. Just clean up the lines here, make some a little thicker, make them a little thinner. Just want to do the outlines of these. Now normally I don't add too much color to my artwork. Actually, a lot of the times I don't use paint at all. I use marker. That's a little close for me, but just convert it into part of it. There we go. Now this one, because we did that, we're going to just do this. Make it a little bit like that now. Alright, so we're going to switch brushes, because I forgot, of course, to get a light brown. That's brownish. A little dab there. That's kind of a golden, but that's all right. Smaller brush. Yeah. We'll give this one a try. It's the worst that can happen, right? Now all this gets painted right up against the edge. I wouldn't worry about too much about the black. You can always take a really fine paintbrush after and redefine the black. Actually, should have probably did the black at the end. But that's all right, we'll just go with it. Oops. That was a little wet still. So we'll have to go over that again. Just wipe off that. The smudging is, I think, the reason I don't do a super lot of painting. I use more the marker type art. Dirty here. Clean it off. I won't show you cleaning all this up. I'll just show you the basic painting. And then maybe on the next video I'll just have this one in the background so you can see how I touched it up. Touch up some of this black again. It's all right. It's also best probably to let it dry in between each little phase. Oops. Touch the black up. Later. I'm just trying to show you guys the basic concept here. I will fix this all up and show you guys later. Just trying to kind of do a rush job here. You guys see. Wipe off some of this excess here. As you see, I can have to fix that black up. Got a little bit of black here. Last brush, we can touch it up here now, I guess. Just kind of touch it. try to find a color that kind of matches, but it's totally different too. Let's go for a dark. Oh no, we don't want too dark. We'll go for maybe I should have thought my colors out before I started here. Let's go for a reddish. This is a coral red. Said you just touch all this up later after it dries. It's much easier than try to play with it when it's wet. This way you can take your time to clean it up. Right now you're just getting the paint down. You clean up all the black lines later. You can touch everything up later. Just to get your main idea down. Got a little bit of black there. That's alright. We'll touch this up. Just remember your three colors. Used for this. Now at this point you've obviously done the beaver. But what I like to do in most of my drawings is put like a circle. Oops, I caught something there. Try to make a circle anyways. This can be any color you wish. I'm going to use a scarlet. Actually, no. I'm going to continue using the coral. We'll continue doing that. Use the coral. again. When this dries a bit, we'll touch it up. Maybe I'll do another video on the touch-ups. I like doing my touch-ups. I also like getting my idea down. There. Now at this point you're just waiting for it to dry. Waiting for it to dry, that way you can fill it in and just do all the touch up. And that's where you used a really fine one, and this time you, even if you take a magnifying glass with you, and that way you can see really tight and close. There you go, a woodland style beaver. Thanks for watching.